This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of First Impressions. Let's see what GW has to offer to us this week, shall we? GW's latest offering is going to be Dark Imperium. All right, then. Aloha, everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to this week's edition of Second Impressions. The models still pretty much look the same as they did. It's Dark Imperium. Again, go watch last week's video. Yeah. There you go. Anyway, nothing new out of GW camp this week. They're doing the same thing Forge World did a couple weeks back when they released Magnus the Red. And when they released like a big kit or a big model, they want a lot of people to buy it. And so they're leaving that as their only offering for a couple of weeks in a row. Seems reasonable. It is a little bit weird to wake up and go, hey, look, let's see what's new. Oh, wait, there's nothing new. Hey, that's fine. It's business. So I understand. Let's take a minute real quick and do just a little update video. How about that? So I haven't been as active as I wanted to be this week, and definitely next week will probably be the same. We are being audited at my job. It's a once-a-year audit that not every, but if you're in the manufacturing industry or if you're in some sort of a service industry, generally speaking, if you provide something to a non-public consumer, so for instance, if you're making something or if you're providing a service to another company as opposed to like the general public, many times you will have to have what's called a TS certification, which is basically this gigantic industry standard for quality and whether or not everything is up to snuff and kosher and you're running your business in such a way that you're not going to negatively impact whoever you're selling your products to. Some companies do not require that if you're a supplier for them, they don't require that you have that. But it does put more reliability on them if there's ever a problem with their finished product that you have provided components for. Being audited next week, so there's a lot of prep work this week going up into the audit, making sure everything is looking on the up and up. And next week, the audit will basically just take up a monumental amount of time every single day. Odds are pretty good. I'll continue working 14 to 16-hour days. And just flat out not have a whole lot of time to come home. And when I do get home, if I can, it's basically fall on my face in the bed and sleep. So I will try to get some stuff uploaded. And one of the things that we're going to start doing again, I've actually got several things filmed, had a really, really exciting. I did have one night this week where I was able to get done by like 8:30, and I got home and I filmed like 6 episodes of Mini of the Week. And I gotta tell you, man, I had a renewed vigor in me for miniatures that I've not had in a while. And I think a lot of it is coming from looking at some of these models that I would not normally have looked at. But I'm gonna do a little preview video probably this week. I may even do it, I might do it Monday, I don't know, for Mini of the Week, because a lot of people don't even know that I do that series, and it's one of those things where if you enjoy the First Impression series, you really are going to like the Mini of the Week series. Like I said, just it's going to kind of be a little bit light over the next week, and so just bear with me, and once we get out of that, everything should smooth out, and I've got they're actually shutting our plant down for a week over the 4th of July weekend, so really looking forward to that. Probably going to do another overnight all-night live painting session if you missed the first one. I'm not quite sure when it's going to be, but I do suspect that it's coming up, and looking forward to that one as well, because that first one was a whole lot of fun. I don't know if I'm going to continue working with the corn guy that's sitting on my table, or if I'm going to go ahead and finish him up and do a different miniature for that live stream instead. But it's going to be a lot of fun, so look forward to that during the week of the 4th of July. Odds are pretty good it will probably be either the Friday before the 4th or the Friday after the 4th. Not quite sure when yet. But anyway, a lot of cool stuff coming up. Really, really excited. I'm jonesing to get back on the painting table and start putting paint to miniatures again. Doing those many of the weeks really, really reinvigorated me as far as my enthusiasm and my excitement for looking at some more unique miniatures that I haven't kind of gotten to lately. And so I'm really, really looking forward to getting back into painting once this audit is done. I don't think I've actually picked up a brush in about a week and a half. So really excited about coming back to the table and looking forward to it a lot. Anyway, that's all I got for you guys today. I'd say I hope you enjoyed this edition of First Impressions, although there wasn't really a whole lot of impression to be had. So anyway, if you missed last week's First Impression about Dark Imperium, feel free to check it out. It's probably over there in that sidebar somewhere or wherever YouTube has decided to put the related videos by the time you watch this video. I'll just do this because it used to be down there and the description used to be over there, and then they swapped it and they put the description down there and they put the related stuff over there. On mobile, I have no idea where it is. It might be up here somewhere. I have no clue. But I do know one thing, that subscribe button, at least for right now, is right down there, and you better click it. Because if you're not subscribed to this channel, you're going to miss out on a bunch of awesome content coming up soon. Anyway, that's all I got for you guys. I really hope that you enjoyed this episode of sort of first/second impression/update video, whatever you want to call it. And that's all I got for you today. So, once again, hope that you enjoyed it. Please leave a thumbs up on this video. Please feel free to leave a comment or a question if you happen to have one. And, as always, make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss these videos. Thank you once again for watching. I really, really do appreciate it. God bless you all. Have a fantastic rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.